So far we've moved up to lecture 6, if I'm not mistaken. And I only did a similar example of two bodies. So I would like to do another one of the billiard balls, and then conclude by looking at the potential.
So we had a body of the body of 0.50. So let's now look at the other example of the billiard ball. In the notes, the example of 3-3, I left out the example of 3-1, which was an example about the cup. And I made sure that in the notes I drew a nice cup and inspire you. So the notes are not readable, so I'll try to write it here. So a two player, I write that as I talk, so when I talk, and you can read and go up and listen up. So a two player hits a billiard ball. And it is the white one, white and red. Just to be clear, you're not if you change the color of mass 0.4 kilograms along the direction. Thank you.
full playing. You are having two billiards. I wish I could come with two billiards balls. I think they are very expensive. So I cannot afford them. So the full players actually do physics. When you ask them to tell the minimum laws of motion, they will say, ah, that thing is fake. For us, we know how physics works. But I assured the first, that first time I did play full, I assured the guy that I'm going to win you because this is physics. And I won. I told him I cannot hit the balls to split over the table, but split them on the table and give me the color, and I will win you. And I won. So the concept is that when you look at the, because I had been playing on the computer, and on the computer you can pass raw lines, and the computer gives you, if you hit it at this spot, it will go this way. So I had the theory of the computer, and I also had the physics theory of elastic collision. So if the first ball, the one which is going to be hit, and then you have another stationary one, so these are the initial, so I would call this one ball one, and this one ball two. Ball two is stationary. This is going to be hit. This is the original situation. Now this is hit. It is 0.4 kilograms. This is 0.3 kilograms. So I hit this with my, how do you call it? That stick we use. What? This one, stick. Whatever, I'll call it a stick. So, you hit it with a stick. And this has a ball, most probably on your, you know, on your pool table. You can visualize this as a play pool. You are around here with your white ball. I guess there are three balls. So probably you want the, this black ball was put there or was left there, and you want to hit it so that it gets deflected to this ball. That's why you see them always looking around and they walk with the balls around. Look at the other side. They are trying to do physics in their ignorance. And then after they have looked at the right angle they can use, then they come back and give it a hit. And then as you can see, it's moving along the X direction. And make sure that you may hit it, because when I say along X, and then they will tell to someone here that not really, we are assuming that you are going to hit it along the X, but it will not hit the ball, it will not impact it head on. With a kind of slight shift on the side. So then the ball will go this side and you have a much more guarantee. So we are interested, sorry, I'm interested in the question in the ball, my ball gets deflected, started, so we wouldn't want it to go in the ball. So let's take the hole where the black has gone, being this corner here. And so my white hole gets deflected this side, and the black one gets deflected to the hole. And assuming I won again. So we want to find out the direction. 5 or 7, depending on which, or alpha, depending on which angle, you always comfortable with different people like different things. So, to complete the diagram, I will be using the direction X for purposes of understanding and visualizing the diagram. And then I will get the deflection of my ball, the
white one, which is B1. The position of ball one after collision, and the ascending. The ball collides with the second stationary ball, you know, mass less than 4 kilometers, the speed was 2 meters per second. And then after collision, the velocity of the fast ball is 1 meter, so it reduces speed for formality and for uniformity. Nice to be back with the same, very small pressure. As a physicist, you should learn how to push your rules. That's why sometimes we are called into people, because we want to see everything working. Needs more power. So you've got your B1 prime there at 30 degrees, and most likely, or definitely, this other ball will get deflected towards the other side. So this is your ball B2. You could have said this is the white ball, you could have said white ball, and then you say the remote prime, and then you call this one a black ball. The black ball after collision. I want you to have that flexibility, but also remain within the limits of physics. Not that you have one workload in the mass, maybe you can use it as you should be able to work as a physicist and find your symbols where being the black ball and you the white ball. Okay, so we now can say that this is better. Then we work out all the other procedures of what we mean by. So, in our experience, we meet moving bodies in a given medium, such media. Could be fluids, and fluids are gases and liquids, and these fluids offer resistance to the moving body. So you were riding a bike, you can't even open your eyes very properly, like if you are on a motorcycle, you can't open your eyes widely. If you are in a car, actually, if you were in a car and someone is driving crazy and the windows are open, you feel like the car wants to fly off. And for those of you who thought that maybe using AC you take a lot of fuel, logically, if you closed all the windows and engaged the AC, because of the much air that flows inside, and because even the engine cools down, no, most of you have not had an experience in driving, but I can share with you. When you are at high speed on a highway, the engine cools down, meaning that while you will be opening the windows, it's to get warm and maybe cool some coolness. So if you close your windows, it means you don't need to engage your AC, it will be a bit low. And then the fuel you would have wasted when your windows are open and your car is dry is saved. So some people will ask and say, somebody hear them asking some media on the radio that is it true AC, you know, consumes a lot of fuel? Not really, if you are using AC in the right place. If you are climbing on the hill on a hot day and there is AC and you are at a slow speed, yes, consume a lot of fuel. It would be advisable at least to open up your windows and get fresh air for free. But if you are on a highway along Ginger Road or Mentebe Road and you want to get some coolness, it wouldn't be advisable to open your windows wide because the resistance. So that's why I'm bringing all this, because when we talk of fluids being gases and liquids, yes, when you are driving, when you are on a motorcycle, on a bicycle, you feel the air, meaning the wind blowing you up, which is the resistance we are talking about. And if you drop a piece of either wood or
something which is not so metallic that it goes through quickly. If you put a ball bearing or a steel ball in oil, you will see this ball moving very slowly in the oil, because oil provides resistance to its motion. Until when this ball can move at a constant speed, something that we call terminal velocity, we should be able to identify the types of media a body moves in. We should be able to determine the force, the forces on a body moving through its media, and maybe we should be able to calculate some terminal velocity for some of the bodies moving in a given place. Now, the space vehicle problem: if a body is moving through space, it needs some resistance. Do you agree? So, if you shoot a rocket, how many of you have ever witnessed a rocket launch? Live or in 3D? Not this one, which they put for Christmas, and then they shoot them for... When can we meet again in the evening, and then I show you a couple of these demonstrations. I can show you a few videos about rockets in space. I can show you the International Space Station and the like. Now, this is more or less like gravitation, which you covered in high school. So if you have the... what happens to the rocket is that whenever you shoot the rocket, the fuel starts burning. The car, yes, for the car, when you ignite the car, the spark plug, gives the spark, fuel is burned, the fuel expands and lifts the piston. Okay? So that process continues. The piston goes up, when the burning is complete, the gases go out, and that's why you see the fuel coming out of the exhaust pipe. That process continues, and then the car moves. I'm going to explain that to show you that the physics people studied those days, or the physics they tried to understand, like Einstein understood a couple of things, Newton just accidentally got hit by an apple. I would say it was a mango, but one German girl almost boxed me that it was an apple. There are no oranges in Germany, so I kept quiet. All these people came with small principles. These principles were fine-tuned and made into things that we are using today. I'm using a digital camera which uses optics, an arrangement of lenses, but I do not have to start adjusting to get automatic. I just press, zoom, and get what I want, and I start recording. Sometime back, you would have to record on a magnetic tape. After that, then you can transfer and listen on the cassette. How many of you use cassettes these days? In my O-level vacation, I think I bought a Walkman from the money, the small man I made, so I would enjoy the cassette tape, and sometimes record a couple of them. So, in a nutshell, these principles were improved and made more sophisticated. So when a rocket is burned, I started from the engine. So when the fuel is burned, it gives it a heat. So depending on the journey from Earth, either to the moon or to the orbit, the backing orbit, depending on where you are putting it, where you are putting this kind of satellite, then you give it an amount of fuel that will keep it there. If I'm going to go to the village, it means I will go to the filling station and put in the amount of fuel that will take me up to home, because I will be able to know each kilometer I use this, so I need these many liters. You get a concept? So the vehicle exerts a backward push against the environment, So we are going to consider two examples of motion of bodies, and these bodies are moving in in space. Now, what is a satellite?
When they talk of a satellite, what do you understand?
Positioning system satellites continually relay radio signals to ground receivers. Those signals contain timing information and data about the satellite's locations. That information is then analyzed and turned into other data that can be used by airplanes and boats for navigation. Automobile GPS systems also use the same information to help drivers find their destinations. Banks and financial institutions depend on precise GPS signals to help them transfer money on time. And every cellular telephone network relies on GPS timing data.
Satellite TV, you know, they say satellite TV, satellite phone for, you know, like the TV, the people from the head, they use satellite. So anybody that is up there in space and is at issue, we call it a satellite. Okay? The natural ones are called planets. So the moon is a planet, Earth is a planet. And I tried to draw diagrams in the north to really give you an impression of what the figure 4.1, this slanting part is the Earth, and then there's a satellite which probes around the Earth. There are a lot of satellites which are up there in space. I know some of you will eventually get inspired to do space science or something of the sort. We have a lot of satellites which take imagery like up here where you speak to Earth. Yeah, so and nowadays if you have a Gmail account, Google Earth, I don't even think you need a Google account. If you go on Google Maps, you can activate a Google Earth mode and be able to fly to your village. Your village has good imagery or current imagery, and then you see. So those photographs are taken by satellites. Some of you who think your homes are secret places, they are not secret places. The photos are being taken by satellites from hand. Depending on the interest of the person who wants the photos, the resolution can be as far as about a kilometer. They can be able to look at your home as far as a kilometer from above and be able to see exactly what is in your house, well, around your house, and how your house looks like. So that is one of an example of results from the satellite. All of you watch Premiership. You are able to get Premiership matches because of the satellite TV. So a satellite for communication, for sending the information back here, is put in what we call a parking orbit or a geostationary orbit. So when you say parking, just from the literal meaning of parking, it seems that it is parked. But we say that is geostationary. Geographically, it seems that it is stationary. So if I install a satellite, my satellite dish at my house, and so the rays come from the satellite, and when they reach here, they all get concentrated from the optic. They all get concentrated from the receiver, which is called an LNG, whatever. The language of satellite communication, and then you get the TV signals in your house. So all you have to do is get your DSTV, digital satellite television dish, and adjust it to face the satellite. Now, as the Earth rotates, the satellite rotates with the Earth pointing at your fish.
And every time, when it is in the night, the two are different in each other. When it is in the morning, the two are in one day, 2 days, a month, a year.
That's why we call them geostationary. Because the satellite up there is moving at the same period or has the same period as the Earth. So they move facing each other. You don't realize actually they are this motion. It's just like if you sat in a bus and you look at the ceiling on the light in the ceiling of the bus. And the bus is turned around on the roundabout and where you are facing up. You keep looking at the same place. But both of you, you and the light in the bus are moving. But you are looking at the light, same light, it's like nothing is happening. If you stood out there and started looking at the technology building, you will keep looking at the technology building until when you die of hunger, if you did what you eat. So in relation to to you and the building, the other side, you are geographically stationary. You are the same place. But the Earth is moving. Except that for the satellite is moving as well as the Earth is moving. So I drew something to show you what the orbit is all about. And mostly the information is that, how about,
so the gravitational, force, of course, the two will attract each other, because any two bodies in space, I talked about it at the beginning, any two bodies in space attract each other. And that's one thing in nature that I find fascinating. Everything attracts each other, how many of the history helps us. So I'm just going to build the thing is called FP and the temperature force. Temperature force are equal but opposite. So I talked about the buckets. If you use one, how many of you have done it?
The much they told me, you can even make one out of it.
You are able to wall a bucket with water and water doesn't fall out, because in water the mass tries to run away from the bucket. So if you look against this arrangement of the three satellites and the satellite of the Earth, for example, this is the Earth, and this is the orbit for the satellite. So this is our satellite, and then we go with a nice view, as it is in the book. So in the north, it's nice and drawn. This one, when you see the satellite being drawn like this, these are solar panels. So what happens is that they put everything in a rocket, which you always see, or which you saw in the background, or something which is like that, with a couple of fuel containers on the side of it. And when it is so, these fuel containers keep rusting off. When it has gone out of the Earth atmosphere, they struggle to go out of the Earth atmosphere. And at times, like when the shuttles were still going to space, you have the shuttle. I don't know what it means. The shuttle. These shuttles had a lot of. I flew on one of them. No, not physical. They told that if you can send your photograph, they will put it in. They will print it and put it in the air. The cabin of the shadow, and when the shadow is back, they'll give you a certificate. So I tried that. I said, why would I go to space? My photograph was in space. So I think I did it for about 3 weeks. So I have 3 certificates.
My tests are developing in space.
So at the bottom of the shadow are some of the tiles to avoid giving up, because as it comes out of the Earth atmosphere to go into the space, it's not easy. It's not something that you say, let me go out of the space and disappear. Like when you are under your phone, like when you are hitting the clouds and you are going to hit through the clouds and stabilize on top of that, you don't go through comfortably. It's not just it's not small. Those clouds that you see, not small. The first time I was traveling, I visited some gentleman, and he told me, when you reach there, you need portholes. I laughed. Portholes in space, that is insanity. So, but when we were taking off, I said, I would want to be able to see those portholes out there. And true it is, it's true that when the plane is up there in space, at times, because I think it helps on the cooling of the engines of the plane, they tend to want to fly in some nice clouds, which are not storm clouds. So you feel like the plane is bumpy because you see in the wings are busy flapping because of that turbulence. And when you meet a turbulent plane, swift, crazy, you feel the portholes. So, that's why they put the tiles on the space shuttle, to avoid the leaning back. Now, the orbit, so I will draw this diagram the most way. I make sure they are, you know, nice looking, give you an impression of how they look like that. In most books, you find the dot here and the dot here for the earth, and then you have this as the radius of the orbit. You have the mass of the satellite, and you have the mass of the earth, this being the orbit. So as I said, that the water wouldn't, you know, fall on you, because there is a force which is trying to take it out of the bucket through the bottom. And because it cannot go out the top, the centrifugal force Fc is this side, whereas the force of attraction Fg is this side. So the centrifugal force and the gravitational force are equal but opposite. So we can basically say that Fp is equal to Fc. If your satellite doesn't kick away from the orbit. So for the satellite to continue being on the orbit, and they are now having also some satellites, the FBO and the Soho. There are many others. This is Solar Dynamics Observatory. It looks at the sun and keeps wondering how the sun behaves. You need to know about these things, because the nature of the sun determines the environment we live in. And this is the Solar Heliospheric Observatory. It's also another satellite which keeps taking photographs of the sun. So gravitational knowledge has helped all these scientists around the world to explore the galaxy. You are not studying mechanics for just passing and getting an A, and then you say, I need mechanics. You should be able to contribute to our society. So, I already had a good summary about the relationship between, just like the charges, the blue force. When you are looking at the blue force, you have two charges, P1 and P2. They attract each other or retain each other depending on their morality. And their attraction or repulsion depends on the product of their charges, or charge magnitudes, and inversely proportional to the distance between them. So we take our test of the arrangement of the yard of mass capital M and the satellite of mass small m. We get the gravitation force proportional to the product of the or an inverse proportional to the square, distance between them square, and the gravitational constant of 6.67 times 10 to the power negative 11 newton meter square per newton, 0 per meter square per kilogram square is what we call the gravitational, the constant of gravitational constant. And the FC would be the relationship between the angular velocity and the distance from the center. So we are looking at this being circular motion of the satellite. So when you did the circular motion in high school, this was preparing you to understand bigger systems in the universe. So this is the M omega squared R. And then if we take away this, we can easily get a few other relationships. Like we can get the angular velocity at which this satellite is moving. So if we wanted to trace or to make this satellite take photos, we can know its speed, we know how long the orbit is, and we can say, let's program the satellite to take photos every after this interval. So we know by this time it will be over Kampala. We take about 4 photos. By this time it will be in Congo. We are not so much interested in the forests. Take a couple of few. So you can use that logic of knowing about the properties, and then you get your 3M of why do we need the angular velocity? I told you, on the practical applications, you would be able to use such a thing or such information for that. The angular momentum, J, is equal to the length, R squared omega, and you go to the knots and get the other wordings which I might have not explained. In the new course, there is an interesting part. Before this satellite goes into the orbit, you must make sure it goes to the orbit. Yes? No. That was for communication satellites. I said it somewhere. All the communication satellites are shot into the matching or the stationary orbit, okay? Those which are relaying the satellite TV, those which are for other communication. For example, if I want to transmit my TV signals to a wider area of other places, that means I need to make sure that my satellite, transmitting satellite. There are two types of satellites. There's a transmitting satellite and the receiving satellite. So my transmitting satellite dish or my transmitter to pass the satellite and give it another satellite will be able to give other places. The mobile phone uses satellite technology, and that's why it is called a cellular phone. It's called a cellular because when you transmit the information to the satellite gives you a couple of cells, and these cells are identified by the towers. So each tower, each communication tower you see for Airtel, for MTN, Grabra, just because competition is in mankind, competition is our stupidity. We wouldn't be having an MTN must be here, Airtel must be here, Mango must be here. We have one must, plug all your stuff, share costs, but we are competing for the same customer. You know? Why should I really carry half of the
one cone. I only put in another line of another telephone just to fill up the two gaps. Don't have two SIM card slots. But I use one SIM card.
I am on Wallet, I want to get married. I want to be Wallet.
Why?
Now I want to throw away the other one and go to get to support the local country. And pay off the money falling out of my country. So I want now, this one is also my network. You see, my mango is found in Uganda, that's why they say. I don't know how much Uganda it is. So I will soon go to KFC and throw away my long time car. So you need to give this satellite to make sure it escapes from the air. And this rocket goes into space, opens up, and then the solar panels come out, communications, the antennas come out, and then people start communicating with it. Pardon? You have not left the earth. Even if you have gone through the clouds, you haven't even reached the earth's atmosphere is the layers of the atmosphere.
Our planet's atmosphere is a blanket of air that is thick near the surface and gets thinner the higher up you go. We live and travel through the troposphere, the lowest part. Next is the stratosphere, which contains the ozone layer and high thin clouds. The mesosphere is where we see incoming meteors burn up. Above that is the ionosphere, an electrified region where space weather has its greatest effect.
And the ionosphere is the boss of communication. Most of you have grown up when you are listening to FM stations, which are localized in your local area, so they are point-to-point communication. When I was young, because the first radio station FM radio was brought about when I just joined the company. And the first satellite was launched when I was being born. Do you believe that? The first GPS satellite, so you can know when I was born, if you know when the first GPS satellite was launched. So the atmosphere is when we talk of the Earth's atmosphere, when you look at the Earth as a ball, to leave that ball and go away to the freedom is what they mean by the Earth's atmosphere. Leaving anything to do with the Earth is that place where you go through is what we call that. It's not about the clouds. It's far away from the clouds. When you fly, the time you go in a plane and you see, when you are on top of the clouds, it feels nice. You feel like, should I go and hang on the clouds and lie there? But they are hollow. You go through. You go through without any support. Yes. I think I need to really leave you and you go to education. But I will answer your question.
Now, they just that a certain layer whereby when they look down on those layers, the animals are not in the
I believe I've talked about everything in this lecture. I've just been checking, apart from the terminal velocity, which terminal velocity really is high school stuff. And so, trust me, you will find that I'm not going to be doing you an example in the North Sphere, because this is something you have done, but I would rather discuss with you these other extrapolations into what is going on in the technology in relation to the force of section. Because these are things you have gone through, and when you go through the notes and the books, you'll be able to expound on your knowledge. But I want to share with you what other people are doing. But ask your questions, please, and your questions, please.
Now,
yes, when you, that's why when you, what do you mean by, there are two issues. This one here, this is not the force of gravity. This is just the force between the two bodies. They experience the force of attraction and repulsion. The force of gravity is this force. I jump and I can't land on there. It's only the ninjas who can do it. Who can jump and they are like, I used to think I can do that. So you jump on the telluses I showed you at home. You jump and you think you can go slowly, but you go like a basket. The other thing, but because it is a garden and it is already steep, you don't get an injury. So there is a point where you reach, like when you are in the lift, have you ever seen it in an elevator? There's a point where you reach and you feel like your intestines are jumping out. So I can advise you, when you are in a lift, make sure you know where you are going. If you are going down, you go down. Make sure you are going down. Don't be there like a stool. The same thing in a car. When you are in a taxi and some guy is about to bend the corner, bend there with him. But if you just sit like this, you'll be this way and when the car is going this way. So the point is that it's when you leave the earth atmosphere, then you become weightless. The space station is just floating in air. The International Space Station. If I happen, if you can agree on the day when we can meet and the evening, and I show you a couple of these videos so that you get an impression of what the galaxy and the solar system is. It is just in space. They have put a couple of modules together with the solar energy, and because they are above the clouds, the energy is 24/7. Only when it gets dark, but when the sun is available and the sun rays, it is full energy. They have no blockage. Here we get the problem of efficiency of our solar, because sometimes the shadow of the tree can cover your solar panel, or sometimes it is hazy or foggy, but these guys are above the clouds. Everything is up for grabs. Every light, every sunlight. It's not the air, it's the layer. Yeah, that's where I lost it when I was trying to tell you about FM station. I don't know who interrupted me. When we were young, when I was young, I used to get radios as far as from Namibia, from my home, at home, in the night, that would be around midnight, because that's when I would be burning my books. I would get some radio from Namibia, I would get some VOA, Voice of America, and on shortwave. So how shortwave works is that the layer, which is called the atmosphere, is the layer of iron. Normally when you have an oxygen molecule and they get the ultraviolet from the sun, this ultraviolet knocks out an electron and leaves this one in positive ion. So this energy is too much in the sky, so it produces a lot of the positives and the negatives. But the electrons are always free to move around, so it becomes a blanket of charged particles. So when you send when you send from your transmitter in Kororo, when you send a signal, which is an electromagnetic wave, electromagnetic meaning that it has an electric and a magnetic component. So if it hits ions, which are electric, then you get reflected back. That is on the point that the frequency is less than the physical frequency. So penetrate through the ionosphere. So a station in Kampala, I would get it in my home district, and I would be able to listen to shortwave. And the radio becomes clearer like in the night for shortwave, not FM. Simply not because there is no noise around, but because now when there is no sun, the multiplication of ions reduces, so the ionosphere, you know, kind of goes a little bit up. So the distance now, the reflection now goes a longer distance. And so the radio from Kampala now comes to your place quickly. Whereas when it is during the day and it is the ionosphere has gone down, so something which would have reflected from here to go far now reflects from here and falls in Masaka. So you tune and you hear something just, you know, not clear. You try, but no way. But in the night, you really get a good grasp of the moon. So that's how the ionosphere works. I think I let you go and enjoy your other lectures. See you Monday in my test. No coughing. Make sure you know things by yourself. And have your permits, your evidence of payment, because deadline is today.